What's going on, you the tube? I am Hot Mess Ness, MUA, otherwise known as Vanessa. And I'm hoping I don't have broccoli in my teeth. Today's video is going to be some of the new makeup that's come out. I know we're constantly flooded with it and, you know, my thoughts on it. There has been a period in time where I actually had to unfollow Trend Mood, turn off the post notifications because it made me feel a little crazy. And now I'm definitely getting a better handle on that. But I thought I would share some of the things that are coming up, like a yay or nay, if they piqued my interest. This isn't necessarily if I say that I'm interested that I will purchase, because I am finding that I'll wanna watch a lot of reviews on something or go in and swatch it and feel it and like really get to know it before I buy, so I'm not just buying to buy. Last edition that I did this, like a week ago, 2 weeks ago, I talked about Looksee Beauty and Divina Cosmetics. You know that those are a yes, and those videos will be coming soon. I think that was it. Yeah. So on to the list of things that I've noticed either on Trend Mood or on some of my favorite indie brands. Sydney Grace is gonna come out with a new bundle. It's a couple teasers. We got some finger swatches, and all that was said is that it's been developed by three teen girls between the ages of 16 and 20, so it will be good for neutral or beginner looks. I love Sydney Grace, so whenever we get more information about it, I will definitely let you know. I'm sure it will be 10 to 12 shades, and that means that it'll range between $32 and $42, and it would be a collab, so it's always good to support because it's going to support whoever she collabed with. Not a lot of information on that, but I'll keep you posted. The next one that I noticed was Becca and Sananas?
2106.
That's her Instagram. And it's this beautiful highlighter that has like the Eiffel Tower in it. And I haven't bought a Becca highlighter in a while, but those things last forever. I have like Opal, and then I have the Jaclyn Hill palette. And I really, really enjoy them, but I just don't pick them up very frequently because they are pricey, but they do last forever. And this one has definitely piqued my interest. I have no idea who that girl is, but the color looks really pretty. The next one, I don't know if I've mentioned this before, but it was the Too Faced Festival Collection. I don't understand Too Faced thought process on this besides that they were the originators of Unicorn Tears lipstick or whatever, and they're really trying to play off that. The festival collection has lipsticks that I'm interested in. It's like an extension of Unicorn Tears. They have like mermaid tears and I don't know, dragon farts and tears, whatever. They look pretty and I'd like to swatch them, but for $22, I'm not so sure that I would take that leap. But out of everything that they have in that big old collection, that's the only thing that's really got me. I don't understand a bronzer that is shimmery. It's just not my jam. I prefer a matte, even a satin bronzer, but I don't want to be sparkly here. I don't even really do cheek toppers, and I know those are big for some people, but that tends to show up, you know, your texture, and I'm not trying to show up more of my texture. They also have a big palette for $42, and it just looks like ginormous. And I have the mermaid palette from Saucebox, and I never use it because the thing is so huge, and as much as the packaging may be eye-catching, it's just not in reality something that I would use very often.
Do you want more grapes?
Okay, I'll get it for you in just a second. That palette is $42. That's a no for me. I know that I have all those shades with my indie brands, and once I see the actual swatches, I'll dupe it for you. And then they have a unicorn brush for $34, and I'm like,
how many unicorn brushes do we need?
No, thank you. Morphe came out with a new 9-pan palette. I don't know what this one's called, but for only $12, I actually saw some of the 9-pan palettes at Ulta, and if I needed a neutral palette, I might go that way. Because of the price point, it's a no for me, but when I felt them and swatched them, they seem nice. So, you know, maybe if you need more neutrals in your life, go to your local Ulta, because more of them are in stores. I actually got to touch the Jaclyn Hill palette, and if I needed something like that in my life, I might have picked it up. But again, that's a no for me. Makeup Forever is coming out with a Starlit Glitter palette. The swatches online, the eye swatches, look really beautiful. But they kind of remind me of like the latest Luxie shadows that I have from the Dollhouse collection. So it's not something that I need nor that I even really want. But they look pretty, but it's a no for me for $45. The crayon palette has become a thing. It's become a thing. Now, if you're looking for more color in your life, I could definitely see it. It's $30. But to me, there's nothing to bridge the gap. It's just red and yellow and blue. And as much as I'm excited by those colors, I need things in the in-between. So I would have preferred if they came out with that crayon palette and made it like the super box, you know, the old school super box of crayons. And so you'd have red and you'd have red violet and then you'd have pink. If they did that, then you'd have a true rainbow palette that you could do all kinds of looks. Then I might be on board for it. But I have a single red from Suva Beauty and I have a red from Sugar Pill. So if you already have all those, you may already have the crayon palette. So maybe they'll come out with a part two that's more gradiating shades, and that I could appreciate. But that one is a no for me.
Lots of no's.
Pat McGrath is coming out with these Valentine lip duos, I believe. I don't have any of her lippies. I don't have anything Pat McGrath besides the first lip things that came out with all the glitter and stuff. But that red packaging is gorgeous.
Aslan! Aslan and Dear Grace.
But the lip duos, it's like her gorgeous packaging with red too. And I'm like, I kind of want it, guys. I kind of want the lip balm too, but who needs a $34 lip balm? But I think that this is one of those things that it's like, the Pat McGrath little lip duo things. I still want one of those lipsticks. I do. Maybe someday. BH Cosmetics is coming out with a L'Amour palette, and I thought for $15.99, if you weren't on board with the Jeffree Star palette, it has some similar colors. It's got that red and, you know, it's much smaller, but it might be a good option for you to check out, and it looks pretty. It's a no for me. So Viseart is coming out with a new Trist. I believe it's like Trust with a Y, Trist palette, and it's supposed to be like similar to the Golden Hour palette. And at first I was like, oh, this might be a chance for me to try Viseart. And then I saw this sneak peek and I'm like, no, boring. If this sneak peek is what the Viseart Trist palette is, it's a no for me. Lime Crime is coming out with these, or they're currently on the website. They're these aquarium brushes, but they're done in Valentine format. There's something about those kind of synthetic brushes that always kind of throw me off. It's anything that does this kind of duo. It just looks cheap to me. I won't be purchasing those. If you're looking for the aquarium type brushes, I believe it's Cosmic Brushes and then also Unicorn Brush, Brushicorn. I did a review on them. If you're looking for that kind of thing, they're indie brand. They're really good quality brushes. And you're still getting that artistry, but they're handmade, and then you know it's a better quality if you're gonna spend that much money. So I will leave those recommendations down below. The next one is the ABH and Amreezy highlighter. There's something about the way that they place that in the pan, and I'm a huge Amreezy fan. I never bought any of her lippies before because I'm not actually huge on liquid lipsticks. And I wasn't sure about the brand that she always collabed with, but I am definitely on board for that highlight. It looks gorgeous. Highlighting is Amreezy's thing, and it just looks like a really special kind of thing to have. I don't know, I'm for that one. $29 coming out Valentine's Day, so that one's a cool one. Another thing that piqued my interest was the Fresh Dream Balm. Now I have a little sample that I got of Fresh from their lip balm. It's the caramel one. The baby took off with it somewhere. It was like one of my favorites too. I was gonna add it into a video for my favorites and then she took off with it. I haven't seen it since. So I'd be interested to try some of their lip balms. This one has a slight tint to it. $26. I mean, do you need to spend $26 for a tinted lip balm? No, but I really like the little pot. So if it was a similar formula, might be interested in that one. Kylie is coming out with an anniversary pack for Posy K, Posy K was a very popular shade, and this one will have the matte liquid lipstick, the gloss, and I believe the satin. And if you're a fan of Kylie, I think, you know, get all three in one little kit, but I don't buy Kylie stuff, at least not yet. Sugar Pill came out with their little Twin Stars palette, and it was two lippies. And I really like the Sugar Pill liquid lipstick formula and more of the like trinket and that kind of thing, because they're more wearable, like normal kind of colors, but they have something different about them. But I'm not gonna wear a bright baby pink, and I'm not gonna wear that blue. It just didn't do it for me. And then the palette was like, I know a lot of people were excited about the palette, and I'm like, there's two mattes. There's a blue and something else, and the rest are all shimmery shades. How can I create a full look with this? This will be a companion palette. And as much as I'm okay with that, I just expected more from Sugar Pill. I guess if you're a little Twin Stars fan, you'd be all about this, but I think that that passed my age. Like, I was not on that kick. I like Sanrio stuff too when I was a kid, but that was not one for me. Jouer came out with blush duos. I think they look really beautiful. I have enough blush though. I don't need a really pretty compact with two blushes in a mirror. I rarely ever care enough to reapply blush. And I have so much blush, I don't need any more. Now, if you're a huge blush fan, I could see it. I think they're only $30 and they look really beautiful, but that's just another one for me. I don't need it. Storybook Cosmetics, more flower brushes, more brushes with something on the inside. And aesthetically, they look really pretty, but they just seem, I don't know, from the pictures, the ends just seem like lackluster. And for me, for that kind of price point, I want functionality in my brushes. I don't want to just have a brush because it's pretty. I don't have a special display for brushes because they have a pretty end. So that's, yeah, a no for me. Until there's a place that I can touch them and feel them, or someone sends me a gift card for Storybook, this is not going to happen. But on the flip side, I'm usually kind of anti-Storybook. I know a lot of people are all about it because it's creative, and I think it'd be so cool to have like all those book palettes, but I feel like there's kind of that line that they're riding on with creative, what is that?
Baby, what's that called when you're taking somebody's creative thought and it's like infringement? Intellectual property.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I feel like they ride on that intellectual property issue, and that's kind of stopped me. But then I saw the cover of the Van Gogh palette, and that might be the one time that I actually break. But see, they're getting at the heartstrings, and that's where I kind of go, oh. So interested in Van Gogh. We'll have to see what the color story is. This is Mac and Jeremy Scott. Now, when I saw this amazing palette that looks like a stereo, it gave me the feels, you know? But it's $75 for this palette, and it looks huge, and there's all this empty space. Now, I understand what you're seeing with the palette is like how a stereo goes up and down, old school boombox. So visually, I get it, but then I think of all that wasted space. So it kind of gets me both ways. Like, the reason I'd want to buy it is also the reason why I wouldn't buy it. And it's hella expensive for a palette, $75. So I don't know, we'll have to see what the swatches look like, but I just don't see that one in my future. The next one I just saw on Trend Mood, it's by Rald Cosmetic, and it's a diamond set, and it's this big ass brush set, and it's like damn crystals all on the edge that are supposed to be like diamonds. First off, I've never heard of this brand before, so I have no idea if they have quality brushes. I mean, I guess if Wayne Goss threw some diamonds on this, I might be on board because I know the quality is good. But when a brand that I've never heard of before, I feel like they put all the money into the brush handle, but how do I know that the brush isn't functional? So I looked at that and I was like, $57 and what, some random 20 cents, which is weird. $57.20. Why not just be $57? Why 20 cents? Ugh. So that's a no for me. Now, this is very rare that you'll hear this from me, but Jeffree Star is coming out with Minnie's Lovesick Collection, $52, and you get Doll Parts, Calabasas, Wifey, Watermelon Soda, Anna Nicole, Prom Night, red rum, and unicorn blood. I think this is great for anyone that's never tried his formula, or maybe you have some of the colors and you don't have the rest. It's an opportunity to try. I love Calabasas, I love Doll Parts, and I love unicorn blood. The rest of them are like meh, and I don't need it. I have a lot of the full sizes of colors I already like. I don't need the minis, but that's gonna be a no for me. But if you don't have those and you wanted to try it, I'm kind of on board with the minis right now. But the Lovesick collection is not for me, not now. The last one is the Kat Von D Divine Official. There's just something about that little palette with the eyebrows that's kind of getting me, but I'd have to swatch it. So I won't be one of those people that jumps on board and goes and gets it online. I'll watch reviews, I'll go check it in store, I'll swatch it, and if it's one of those things I can walk away from and think about and really want and come back and get later, then I might get it. But, you know, I find that so many things are pushed in our direction and then we don't ever use it. And I don't know how many of those colors are really gonna be insanely pigmented and cool. So that's a maybe. So my list wasn't very long of yeses. Actually, I don't think anything was like a for sure. It was just maybe if Sydney Grace's new bundle is cool in a few months, I'll get that. But the one thing I was like, I really think I might want that is the VisiArt. And then I saw the sneak peek that could possibly be it. And I was like, no. So Amreezy. Amreezy wins.
Did I have lipstick on my teeth?
All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. That was my list of new makeup releases and would I buy or not so much. And we'll see you guys in the next video. Mwah! Bye.